back at home now. Finally, I finally heard the entire album. I'm going to apologize in advance. Sorry for the quality. Sorry for the mic quality in this shit. But if y'all thought, well, I mean, it's already been damn near a week, but hey, we here now. So, hope y'all enjoyed the video. Please head on over to Twitch and don't miss out on all the dope stuff that we be doing over there, because it's a really good community, man. And y'all will see in this video why this is a good community and why the damn live streams be good as fuck. So, hey, enjoy the Donda released while I was on vacation. I reacted into the hotel. Enjoy.
Hey, I try to be cool. Thank you. Dude, wow. So we on some let's hide the features type shit. I'm with it. Dude, I love the Donda intro. I love jail.
Donda.
Whoops,
Donda.
My bad.
I know God breathed on this. I know he got his hands on this. I know we got a chance on this.
Did this nigga just say Did he just say God gonna make children of this? God gonna make children of this. Why is this song already liked? I liked it without hesitation. Okay, at first I thought he shouted out Justin LaBoy. I was about to be pissed for a second. Now, when he says, "Does God? I know God breathes on this." Is God? That doesn't even feel like a right statement to say. I can't say it. Is God projecting male feces on this track? That is not. There's no way that's not Post Malone. There's no way. This song mid, Raccoon, you need some God in your life, bro. We're not talking about mid right now. We're not talking about mid right now. Can I get a fat, wet kiss? No. Yeah. Who the
Corby. We off the grid.
I'm off the grid.
When I was in jail, I was low key. Shout out to supporters that wrote me. Eat food, work out, and then go sleep. You know I'm praying he carrying both feet. Smarter, my grind harder, and my car quicker. I'm a hunt.
Christian Kanye is on a drill beat right now. Christian Kanye is on a drill beat right now.
I just in my backyard. I think I see Messi, and his money could never neglect me. I pray that my family would never resent me. And she fell in love with me soon as she met me. We both got a bad mind. My back is more.
Are we going to have to get a new subgenre? Christian drill? That nigga got to get the Messi bar out there, though. Wow.
This in 3D. All lights out for me. 80 degrees.
Yeah, walking on the beat.
I know you won't.
I'm in a hotel and I can't get my full reaction.
Oh.
I'm trying to bounce off walls right now. Am I tripping? Or is that 5 out of 5? Is that 5 out of 5? Each and every song. Even the Donda chant. I loved it. And this nigga Abel Soji shouts out, well, hints at his fuck. Well, it's not even a hint at this point. Brings up his album that is finna come out soon in his verse. That's giving some good press right there. That nigga knew what he was doing when he said that. Oh, dude, get ready for the dawn, bro. I don't think it's coming out this year, but I hope it comes out this year. But I think it might come out in 2022.
Night.
Sir, yes, I do work. Work 6 of like Mike. 2 man like I.
He's not missing.
Yeah, I'm shaking the drop.
The
devil my eye.
Travis.
Can't pay me to stop back to life.
This is good. This is good.
We gonna praise our way out the grave.
This is good.
Speaking praise God, walking out, serve. Follow your word.
Who has the Marge emote, dude? Who's that? Is that Baby Keem? There's no way.
Let's get right. Want to save your life, rentals and
insurance, you know what I mean. Wait. And I'm five, I don't channel 10 till it's okay, this is so weird. I need the explicit version.
Yo, oh my god.
Dude. He's here. He's literally here.
The only supremacy that we support is Baby Keem supremacy. These niggas are really, like, they are with Baby Keem, dude. Baby Keem. How old is Baby Keem?
Baby Keem is 20 years old.
And he already has a feature with one of the greatest artists of all time. And another great artist of all time. And another artist that is one of the best of our generation. No. We cannot just say, oh, of course, it's because it's Kendrick's cousin. Because I don't feel like Kanye would just grab someone just because they're... Well, I mean, just because of what he said to the baby, maybe. But Baby Keem got some talent, bro. Like, I don't think these people are doing features with him just because he's Kendrick's cousin. Because just because you're someone's cousin doesn't mean you're good. Keem is actually really talented, bro. And he already has a feature with artists that really aren't that easy to get features, because it's so easy for an artist just to say no. But to have a feature with Kanye, Travis, already in Kendrick, I understand it's his cousin. But damn. We got a Keem verse with Kendrick 2 days ago. And days later, he's on a Kanye album. That's crazy.
And we ain't see it. I lost my brother when we was millionaires. I wasn't scared. His pops got out to see his son killed.
Dude, all these people sound so familiar. Who is that?
I can be the cleanest millionaire.
Oh, that's Lil Durk.
Like that. It get ugly like that. Can't get no money like that. Holy Father, please let me step in.
Yo, Vori's going off. Because even the track he was on before, it was good.
I need a shoulder to lean.
I don't care about the length anymore. Dude, the artists that are on this album, they're gonna get attention regardless, dude. Drake, this where? I'm sorry, I had to rewind that.
You gotta play your friend. You the type to cut the grass and snake your bestest man.
Is that a Drake diss?
Cleaning my house, told him be a use. Bossy disloyalty, then we gon' cut him loose.
That was one of Yachty's best verses I've ever heard. And what I meant by one of Yachty's best joints, because I feel like when I listen to Yachty sometime, I just feel like his auto-tune just be sounding weird. And on that, it just felt like we got his voice naturally for it. Like, of course, there was still a little bit of auto-tune in there, but it just felt like it wasn't overpowering like how some of his songs are. I feel like when it comes to albums like this, like when it comes to a Tyler album, a Kendrick album, someone that is just of high class and demands good music, I just think, let's slow down. Slow down. We're going to get there. I'm finna slap some of y'all in a minute, dude. If I was in front of y'all, some of y'all, and someone's in my face saying, play the song already, I would have slapped you with my backhand, and I ain't even a violent person like that. But we gonna play it, though. Yo, those 808s are blamming. They're thooming.
Cardi?
I love that Patrick emote. I love that.
Dude. Oh my.
Yo. Yo. My men and my women. Yo. Yo. Yo.
Protected. Don't tell. Dude. Oh. The snippet.
Yes. I've had Doo-Wop Thang on replay so much this year, dude. The bass on that song is the best bass I've ever heard in my life. Even if I gotta do it with no promo, I ain't got my point across. You know I'm not about it. Showed you my heart. I let you into my toss. Is this the nigga that sang, I've got the dream, red roses too? Was that him?
Okay. I went through a fit when you said you wanted to leave. I
told you. Talk about Louis Armstrong.
You don't smoke it.
Everyone spam, we gonna be okay right now! Spam it! Give me the cookie. Give me the cookie. God's not finished. God's not finished. Bro, I don't need a kiss, I'm fine. This is beautiful.
We gonna be okay. We gonna be okay.
God's not finished. God's not finished. Dude. Dude,
please don't ask again. Who's up in the van? No control.
What? I'm tweeting. Is this supposed to be this good? Is this supposed to be this good? And Young Thug verse was so good, dude. He really added it. Why did he? Don Toliver.
Here we go, strapping we up. Never forget all the memory. Angels they say I'm not ever weak.
This album right here done taught me never judge an album by its album length. Cause sometimes I be getting nervous. When I see something that's this length, I get scared because it's a lot. It's a lot. This nigga added a global wobble, swivel, wobble, swivel, wobble, slob. How the fuck you make that even harder? My nigga, is that Michael Jackson?
Is you, you know, we with you straight from Beirut, Chicago, Beirut, devil, lay down, devil,
dude.
Lay down, this
my mother. Devil. I'm so, dude, Kanye, I'm sorry. Kanye, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, Kanye. Hey, those are Christian guns. Those are water guns right there. Those aren't guns. Those are water guns.
Got a chance to share not only what he has meant to me.
Is that actually
what he has meant to a writer said we came
is that actually
not just line of generations who came before
you're
us.
Kidding.
The king, the power,
and the power,
and the
oh yeah. Glory, glory.
And why Kanye ain't scared.
Wow. Dude. He's got the Infinity Stones on this bitch, bro. Jay-Z, 5-0, Cardi, Baby Keem, Ariana back vocals, his mom, Don Toliver, The Weeknd, Lil Baby, Kid Cudi. He got the best artist in the world right now. I guess we could say Lil Yachty, Young Thug, Travis. This is crazy. We're in Endgame now. Okay, dude. Why did you have to say her? Was that my gun? Dude. And West Side Gun just came out with an album too. These niggas are smart. Dude, that is perfect.
For me says she left it in God's hands.
Conway the dude.
So I'ma leave it in God's hands.
It's innocent, so I don't stress, I pray and strategize.
It's so good, dude. Yeah, y'all might as well just spam out the What's Up YouTubes at this point. We're ascending. We're literally all Christians at this point. Now we've been yo, future me.
Man, it's hard to be an angel when you're surrounded by demons. I watch so many people leave, I see them change by the season. That's mama seasoning, God got you. The devil's watching, he just peeking in. I just, suicidal thoughts got you wondering what's up there. And why they introduce a party, they say it's up there.
I'm Tondronica coming through your monitor. Back in the great yonder.
J Electronica?
I never rode the Toil Negro local. I shake the tectonic plates of the game if I lay one vocal.
You might not have been a is home that, one that could have did that, but you
is that a pastor
that decorated through this journey, and we haven't even been to jail.
Oh, Larry Hoover Jr.
Looked at and treated us here. Free my father, Mr. Larry Hoover Sr.
In the name of the true and living God, the beneficent, the merciful. Thank you for bringing me up.
So Evan said, what's the point of not putting the features on the songs? I personally like when artists do that because it's almost like it's a surprise. Like, for example, everyone thought Jay-Z was not going to be on there. Do you understand how many people probably went crazy when Jay-Z popped up on the first track? That caught me off guard because I thought that nigga was the fuck up out of here. And then not only that, when you hearing songs and then just a feature that you just not think is going to be on the album is just here. Like, I'm pretty sure people thought knew Don Toliver would be on the album just because he was seen at the stadium. But Baby Keem, who thought Baby Keem was going to be on this album? I didn't think Baby Keem was going to be on this album. That nigga been killing it. It's just so fun. Yeah, just hidden features just make it even more fun. Just like J. Cole. Because then after the album is like out for a few days, then they put the features on. That's what J. Cole did. Because J. Cole didn't have any features on his album, and then they put the features on it like a few days later. But this song right here is perfect. I asked earlier if this song is on the same level with Runaway. Because with how deep this song is, bro, I feel like after a few years or a few months passes, man, this will be looked at as one of Kanye's best songs, bro. And not only that, are we supposed to have this album right now? Because if this man Kanye is on fucking Instagram and saying, oh, the record label just released my album without my permission, what does that mean?
Last Thursday, wear a different color jersey.
This was some graduation type shit.
Dinner thieves, every man disguised, huh? Keep your mask on, keep
Chris
your
sanitized,
huh? It's a roller.
The Sunday Choir make did it. This is some graduate, dude. Look, mama, my nigga, is that Pop Smoke?
There's no.
Why? Why? Yeah, just like Mr. Bird Jesus said, what the fuck just happened? That record label has no fucking respect. You could literally hear the fucking beat in that man headphone. And what was that piano? Yo, you're Universal.
Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you!
That's fucked up. This dude sound like some Jaw shit.
It's so bad.
God on the building, time when silence a luxury. Cussing that
Weezy out of here.
Your gun offset.
Weezy out of here on this bitch.
Famous, I remember back before the chains, we was nameless. Went through the
club, whatever I was
raised in. Money said I was mad at the Grammys.
Before Chief Keepers, bang bang.
Speed. We got Daddy up in the building, get VIP.
You know where to find me, they cannot define me, so they crucify me. House of flames when I leave, come and purify me, come and sanctify me. You the air that I breathe, the ultra, ultra light beam, brought a gift.
Hey, well, while I'm back at home, I'm no longer in the fucking hotel, but we're here at home, you know? Extremely late on this Donda shit, but it's fine. We here. We are here. Oh, hey, It's been a few days to process it. I really haven't listened to the album like that, but it's still the same thing that I've been saying on those live streams. I love this album. Pretty sure a lot of people were shocked right when the album first came out, man, but we're finishing this. We're finishing this right here, right now. He's the miracles. He's... Would you fucking talk to me? This nigga just teasing me. Come on right now. No trouble, love you. Fuck it. Ooh. I don't think anyone has said this, but that beat and the organ and shit, bro, it really reminded me of Mr. Crowley by fucking Ozzy Osbourne. I just really had to quickly pause it because that shit is really reminding me of that song, bro.
He's done miracles on me.
There we go.
Guess who's going to jail tonight?
I can't let my mom hear this. She gonna run in. There has been a lot of controversy with that song, mainly because obviously it has Marilyn Manson, and because it has DaBaby. DaBaby recently going through all the homophobic stuff that he said at Rolling Loud and Marilyn Manson, and all the sexual things that he's, the sexual allegations that he's been through. And that makes me want to bring up that one review that someone did, man. Like, someone really gave this album a 0 because those two guys were on the album. And, you know, I understand that, you know, those two men right there, they have done some things that were really shitty and have done some things that are, like, really fucking horrible. But should we, like, because I want to know what you guys do. Do you guys base it off of the music, or do you guys base it off of someone's past and the shit that people are going through personally? Because me, in my personal opinion, I didn't think DaBaby's joint was bad. And hell, I didn't think Marilyn Manson's part in the song was bad. But just because I don't think their parts are bad, that doesn't mean I support them as human beings. I'm pretty sure that we can say, like, dude, their parts did not sound bad at all. Are they pieces of shits of human beings? Yeah. But in terms of music, them niggas didn't sound bad at all. But to that person that gave this shit a 0 just because those two are here, I really feel like that's unfair to Kanye, because we've got a whole entire album of 27 songs that really sound extremely good. And in that review, the motherfucker barely even talked about majority of the album and majority of, like, lyrics that were really deep. They just pinpointed the fact that, oh yeah, these two men are on this shit, I'm not even gonna give it a rating. And it's at that point where it's like, are you a music critic, or are you a person that reviews someone's life in a personal standpoint? Because it's like, are we, it's like I said, are we here to review the music, or are we here to review how people live their life and how people do shitty things? I don't know why Kanye called up Marilyn Manson. I don't know why Kanye called up DaBaby. Maybe he did it for press. Maybe he's like one of those guys that probably says, oh, God gives second chances, some shit like that. I don't know. But I am not going to give an album a really bad rating just because a certain, you know, crowd is here, just because two certain people are on the album and they've done shitty things. So I don't support DaBaby, I don't support Marilyn Manson, but I can say that their parts weren't that bad at all, and I'll leave it at that. Track 25, Okay Okay Part 2. I do not give a damn about Marilyn Manson, I do not give a damn about DaBaby. Them niggas, honestly, all I can say is I don't give a fuck about them. Ooh, we got some Jamaican flavor in this, so I fuck with it.
Junior Watanabe, you're my re.
Junior Watanabe, you're my dad. 4-5 summers.
Tell me if you know someone that needs.
J Electronica, hard. I'm hard. This shit, hard. We all hard. Like, Jada kissing this bitch. And that's the album, man. After a course of a few days, I finally finished it, and now I can finally give my damn thoughts. At first, like I said in the beginning, I was really worried about this album. At first, I didn't, well, and I can, you know, it's like, and I gotta come clean, and I gotta say, I was wrong. Donda did come out this week, Certified Lover Boy actually came out this week. No, I was wrong. Yeah, I missed. I don't miss much, but this week I missed. The albums actually came out, and this one, I really enjoyed it a lot, bro. I really don't see any. There is a few things on this joint that I feel like shouldn't have been here. The Pop Smoke joint, you know, I understand that it's a tribute to Pop Smoke. I understand all of the hopefully all the proceeds go to his family, but and like I said, I understand it's a tribute. But when you do a tribute, I really feel like there should be more respect there and make sure that the song is actually good and not just something that is just randomly put together. But I am extremely happy that Kanye did do that for Pop Smoke and his family. Favorite songs off the album, 24. Without question, that is my favorite fucking song off the album. I've already listened to that song like 10 times already. That is without question my favorite song off the album. Jesus Lord, another phenomenal song, extremely deep song. I don't know what I was thinking when the song first came out. I was over here talking about some damn, oh man, it's up there with Runaway, but I don't know. I think I was smoking a little bit of something when I said that, but it's a really great song, man. And for post like not cursing Kanye to come out with a song like that so deep, it's up there in my personal opinion. Hurricane with Lil Baby and The Weeknd, such a great song. Like, there's a lot of gems on this album. Off the Grid, it is so crazy hearing Kanye rap over a damn drill beat, dude. We finna have Christian Drill up in this bitch, bro. And I like the way he rolled out the album because it was a whole bunch of twists and turns. A lot of people thought Jay-Z wasn't going to be on the album. A lot of people were shocked that he changed up the songs. But in reality, he really didn't change up the songs. This album was legitimately just so damn long that he just had so many different versions of songs on the live show. So I really like the way he did it. I'm not sure that we were supposed to get this album on a Monday since apparently they released this without permission. Don't know why there wasn't a damn cover art. I really like the original cover art that we had originally seen. The Lauryn Hill song sample was fucking fire. This was a really good album to me, bro. And it says a lot for me, especially because I don't really fucking listen to long ass albums like this. And the fact that it was an hour and 48 minutes, almost 2 hours, 27 songs, and I've came out with a lot of fucking songs I enjoyed, that's a fucking up for me, bro. And I'm pretty sure a lot of people thought the same when they saw that this album was this long. So hey, enjoy the album a lot. Certified Lover Boy coming up next, and not only that, everyone get ready for this album as well. I'm gonna be reviewing this on the vinyl, so get ready for some Drake. Get ready for Little Sims. Get ready for Soul Smoothie. Get ready for those albums. Sorry that I've been, you know, delayed. I love y'all. I love my girl. I love all y'all, bro. So, hey, thank y'all for the support. This be your boy, Mr. 2K God. And I'm out.